Plasmic is a visual UI builder for React. In this demo, we'll create a subset of the to-do MVC app. We resemble a design tool and aim to give you the same sense of speedy iteration, except that you're building the actual product. You can create things from scratch, but here we'll show importing a simple existing design using our Figma plugin, which performs all the tedious low-level conversion of Figma's document representation into web standards. One of the core philosophies in Plasmic is that you should be able to start by drawing or importing messy exploratory designs and incrementally refine them into robust production-ready components using concepts that you can only express in Plasmic. Now, I want to turn these tasks into multiple instances of the same reusable component called task. Now, I want these tasks to be different, so I'm going to double-click this component to drill into editing it. So this is a feature where you can edit the primary copy of the component directly in place, and it lets you design in context from wherever the component is actually used. I'm going to convert this text to what's called a slot. And now from outside of the component, from any instance, I can type in the arbitrary text that I want. Besides text, I can insert any content and any number of elements. It's a flexible way to achieve component composition and communicate in your component or your design system that this particular way of overriding things is allowed, which helps your design system scale. Next, I'm going to pop this component out into its own artboard, and this will let me edit it directly without having to keep double-clicking into it. Now, often with components, you'll want to design them in a bunch of different states. So in Plasmic, we have this concept of variance, and it's a powerful way to express the different states or types or variations of a component. Now I'm going to create a group of variants called states. This is so I can design my tasks that are completed, that are being edited, that are marked as high priority. So the way variants work is they're kind of like layers in Photoshop. You specify overrides on top of the base appearance of the component. For this video, I'll just design the completed state. I want this checkmark that I'm just going to grab from the Figma file. I'm going to paste it and adjust it on a pixel level. And remember, we're editing the completed state, so this checkbox is only going to show up in the completed state. To show you what's going on, I'm going to toggle between the two states so you can see the difference. I can also pull up a new view of the same component so I can see the two states side by side. This is also super handy when doing responsive design. I can make a variant override anything in the component, so I can also make this text style differently. Next, we'll add a hover variant where we'll make the checkbox darker when you hover on any part of the task. And this is the core editing flow in Plasmic. We want to give you direct manipulation with instantaneous feedback, so you're not guessing and checking presentational code, looking up CSS minutiae, or copying values back and forth with browser dev tools. Now we can preview this effect in live mode and feel it out for ourselves. I'm noticing that another thing that I want is for the checkbox itself to have a hand pointer when you hover over it to help with the click affordance. I'm going to go ahead and set that and then I'll try it out again. Now I'm going to go back to my main screen and set a few of these tasks to be completed. One way variants are powerful is that you can combine them. So for instance, we can see here what a task that's both completed and hovered would look like. This is especially relevant for people working on design systems. Even the simplest component like a button has a ton of different states. You've got your pressed and disabled and hovered buttons, and you also have different types like primary and secondary buttons, or different size buttons like large and small, or different colors. And variants are a powerful way to model all these different concepts declaratively. Just a last couple things. I'm giving a name to this element containing all the tasks to keep things organized and to help with code gen later. And I'm going to turn this whole screen into a component as well. So next is when the magic happens. We're going to take this design we created, and we'll make it real. We'll export it into a codebase. You can quickly play with the code right in the browser using our code sandbox integration. With a single click, you can see your design running pixel perfect as a standalone web app. Or to integrate into a local codebase, you can click the CodeGen toolbar button to see instructions on how to do this in a few simple steps. So we provide this command line tool called Plasmic. When you want to start using Plasmic on a codebase, you run Plasmic init, and it creates a small plasmic.json. Next, we're going to copy this Plasmic sync command that uses the project ID. So now it syncs down two components. You can see that this codebase is just a blank create React app. I have the code and the running app side by side. For now, I'm just going to get things onto the screen, so I'm going to edit the main entry point of the app, and I'll replace everything that's currently there with just rendering the to-do app component. And with that, we have exactly what we created in the design tool running in your own codebase. We'll take a look at what these components look like. In the default CodeGen scheme, we generate a library of presentational components, like this Plasmic to-do app component. I'm going to make it render some real data instead of the static list in the mocks. The idea is that now developers can wire up the real props, the event handlers, the real data. We support multiple CodeGen schemes, so if you prefer directly editing a JSX tree, for instance, you can work like that as well. But the real highlight here is that this is not just a one-time CodeGen where once the developer makes their edits, the design and code are forever disconnected, but we actually let the latest design changes continually merge back into the codebase. I've turned on watch mode, so you can see the edits that I'm making in the studio, which I'm going to put on the left, stream directly into the running app, which I put on the right. I'm going to show completely changing the layout of the app to go from this vertical list to a bunch of tiles. I'm adding some layout into the card itself. I'm going to pop this checkbox out of the auto layout and have it float at the bottom right. Now we had this vertical stack, but I can easily change it to a horizontal stack. And you can see just a few of the more advanced layout options at play here, like having the stacks wrap around and introducing horizontal and vertical gaps. The idea is to give you a full-powered layout engine, but not just be a GUI for specifying CSS. We've spent time distilling this down into a set of fast and intuitive controls. So with Plasmic, we want to give you a faster and nicer way to build your presentational components with a single editor that's accessible to both developers and designers so we can keep both teams on the same page. So that was it for this tour. Thanks so much for watching, and we are really excited to see what you create.